Why Haikyuu Ruined Sports for Me. Before addressing the title, let's just first discuss Haikyuu. Haikyuu for Me is the anime that makes my heart tremble like none other. Sports anime is a very character-dependent genre. If you hate a team, then you won't want to watch their respective match. This will make the entire arc feel like it's dragging and not make the viewer feel the emotions the characters are feeling. But that is what makes Haikyuu sell from his competitors. There are no weak side characters in Haikyuu. In Haikyuu, the mangaka Haruichi Furudate doesn't shy away from giving two or more chapters/episodes for a new team. Even recently, the match of Nekoma had taken two episodes. At this duration, the main cast of characters were rarely seen. This much attention to the side characters is very rare to see, which is the appeal of Haikyuu for me. Every match given increases the stakes that much higher. You always end up feeling, how are they going to win against this beast of a team? The side characters are truly fleshed out in this anime. However, having strong side characters has its defects as well. If you put a spotlight on the side characters, the main cast of characters start to lose their shine. A viewer might start to feel more emotional connection to the side characters than the main cast of characters. This can be a huge problem later down the line. At the end of the day, they are side characters and they won't be given much attention like for the main team. However, I have rarely seen people say that I like Shiratori Zawa more than or Aoba Joshi more than the main team. Like I said, the side characters develop in such beautiful ways, but the main team is at a different caliber. Every arc given, there is always something new that is added to the list of things that I love about the main team. They are known as the Flying Crows, the Karasunos. Karasuno team has a huge family vibe to them. You have got Sawamura, the captain of the team. He is the foundation of the group, receiving clutch spikes and acting as a moral support to the team. Asai is the ace, the powerhouse of Karasuno, who assures the team that any wall can be broken. Kageyama is the freshman setter, the king of the court, that sets so accurate it's like a sniper rifle taking its aim. You have got Tsukishima, the lazy freshman whose blocks are very annoying. You have got the hard-boiled dragon, Tanaka, who always gets mocked but never loses his tenacity. His tenacity will make his opponents cower in fear. You have got the coolest person in the whole team, the one who will receive every ball given to him, Lightning Slide Nishinoya. And lastly, the main character, the agile monkey, the greatest decoy there will ever be, Hinata. And this characterization is from my brain and not from the wiki, which certifies that these characters are rememberable and add colors to the black and white of Karasuno. Haikyuu is an underdog story of Hinata that wants to be the little giant of Karasuno. From the very first episode, we see the moment in Hinata's life where he fell in love with volleyball. I immediately knew that this anime will be special when Kageyama and Hinata set their foot on the same team. The only other shonen where I got this family vibe is from the almighty One Piece. Like the Straw Hats, this show makes you think that you are a part of the group, part of their family. When they feel sad, you cry. When they are happy, you laugh with them. It's just a special vibe that only these two anime have shown to me. They like the family I never had. The way you see Karasuno develop across the runtime of the anime is very inspirational. They do still have talents gifted to them, but they are still underdogs in the anime because the teams they face have honed their talents into lethal weapons. The Chadley Oikawa is the setter that brings out most of the talents in his teammates. Also, the impact of his serves on the court is no joke. Wakatoshi is a one-man beast, capable of breaking through any walls with his powerful strikes. However, Atsumu was one of the players I was very shocked to see play. The way he captures the scene when he spikes is breathtaking. You can teach skills to a player, but you cannot teach charisma to a person. Dude can set balls at awkward positions. He can play as a striker. He is just an all-rounder player whose hard work shows in his plays. To have a chance to even beat these powerful players, the Karasuno team go through painful discipline and rigorous training. From this, they develop in brilliant ways. Kageyama was dubbed the king of the court because in the past, he was a selfish player that monopolized the ball to himself. In contrast to present, he has become a team player that worries about his teammates. Asahi is a weak-spirited person, but he will never have his back against the team ever again. But Tanaka's development was the most heartwarming for me. We all can relate to this mentality at some point in our life. It's the prodigies scattered throughout our life who create our inferiority complex in us. Their success make us feel worthless. Their accomplishments make us doubt our own potential. This inner monologue happens to Tanaka as he doubts himself because of the amazing people on his team Karasuno. In midst of all these geniuses, he feels like he hasn't contributed anything to this team and feels out of place. Dejected Tanaka requests Kageyama to not set to him, but Kageyama still says, "I will set to you." Seeing the trust given to him by his teammates, he clenches his fist and shoots the most beautiful side spike I have ever seen in all of Haikyuu. That was a big highlight for me. Lastly, Hinata intentionally receiving the ball for the first time and Kageyama saying "nice receive" right after that made me joyful because I know how Hinata felt being the ball boy of the camp, the clown of the circus. But since this was the case, his alright scene right after that gave me so much satisfaction. I feel happy, especially when other players respect his talent, ethic and hard work. But for me, the best character development was for Tsukishima. He is the lazy, unwilling player that plays volleyball without much passion. But in the match against Shira Torizawa, he for sure was the MVP of the match. The part where he finally blocks Uchiwaka and screams, let me tell you, that scene is still my favorite moment in all of Haikyuu. This is how you should develop a character in any media. It did not feel out of place and in the end, it left me with an emotion I cannot explain with words. So, to address the title, why Haikyuu ruined the sports for me. See, growing up I was a huge football viewer. I watched all leagues and stayed up late to watch my favorite games. Watching football made me rile up in excitement. But after season 3 of Haikyuu, Shira Torizawa vs Karasuno, everything changed. The 10 episode long season was packed with hype, emotion, enjoyment and excitement. The chants of Shira Torizawa echoing across the hall were resonating despair and hopelessness. Everything was against our team. But the way they won was very welcomed as it did not feel like it came out of nowhere. They struggled so hard the entire match, from the guest block beast to the striving ace to the very ace, everything seemed to imply a loss. This match is one of the best shonen fights in all of anime. Nishinoya and Tsukishima shined in this match the most for me. Nishinoya unwavering trust in him and Tsukishima big brain were the most lethal weapon in this match. From chance balls to mistakes to epic moments to the pacing to the character interaction, everything was perfectly handled. This excitement was never topped after this, hence ruined sports for me. Haikyuu is definitely a modern classic that should be watched by everyone, even if sports anime isn't your forte. Thank you for watching if you have reached at this point of the video. I really appreciate you. Have a good fun morning, evening, whatever. This is Dungeon signing out.